Today would have been Betty White's 100th birthday. In light of the celebration and to honor her life, many people donated to animal facilities.
It's part of the Betty White Challenge. Alexis Carpello spoke with local shelters today. Alexis, they tell you the donations are going to help in many ways.
Yeah, that's right, Eric and Hannah. Some shelters we spoke with today say they're blown away with the number of people donating in honor of Betty White.
Today has just been nonstop. We've gotten so many donations.
Donations have been flowing into Rockford area shelters, sanctuaries, and wildlife rehab facilities as residents honor Betty White.
We didn't even put anything out there, and the people have just brought it to us, so it's been great. This is just so awesome to see the community coming together and donating to different shelters. I've seen, you know, not just to us, but different ones in the area as well. We have been getting donations from all over the United States. It's great to see. It can do so much for us. We're going to use it for so many different things, for the animals and, you know, just doing whatever we can.
From house pets to wildlife, the viral challenge helped the local wildlife center raise funds.
And this will help with all the supplies of the surgery room. We're going to upgrade it so it's really top of the line.
Elizabeth Croning donated to Who Haven. She says she shares the love of animals just like Betty White.
I followed them for a long time on Facebook and just kind of watching what they're doing. And I love that, yes, not just cats and dogs. There's all kinds of animals that need help out there. And
Bark on Mulford, a pet boutique, helped raise money for a local rescue group.
We were able to raise $450. And our beneficiary for the challenge was Care for Pets. We had a lot of new people that even came in just for that reason that had never been there before but wanted to participate. So that was an awesome thing to have them make the trip and effort just for that reason.
I'll share links to the shelter and wildlife center in this article at mystateline.com. Eric, Hannah.